Summer is winding down here in Finland, and as the weather turns colder, my attention turns to indoor pursuits. So I recently re-watched all of the Marvel movies. And as I was watching Iron Man 2, it occurred to me that honestly, that movie is so overstuffed, it serves as an excellent case study in why not to do overstuffing. So today, let's take a quick look at what overstuffing is and how to avoid it. Welcome to Just In Time Worlds with Marie Mullaney. Overstuffing is when you jam too many storylines or even too many world-building elements into a single piece of content. The reason why Iron Man serves as such a great example of this is because there are three distinct storylines that could each have been their own movie. The first is that Tony Stark is busy dying from palladium poisoning. He has issues with his father, and he has a love affair with Pepper Potts. He resolves this storyline by figuring out his issues with his father, figuring out the element that his father left a blueprint for, figuring out how to synthesize the element, and giving Stark Industries to Pepper Potts. That whole sequence of events could have been a movie. The second plotline that exists is that of Tony Stark and the government seeking to replicate his technology, and his rival seeking to replicate his technology. Could have been a movie by itself. And finally, the story of Whiplash, a villain created by Stark Industries, whose genius is the equal of Tony's, is an amazing story that would have shone had it been given the space to do so. Iron Man is still a very watchable movie though, because it is well done and each story does get enough attention to actually lead you into feeling satisfied. For an example of how overstuffing really ruins a movie, let's turn our attention to Wonder Woman 2. Wonder Woman 2 is like a museum tour where the museum guide is trying to hustle you out the door. If you look to my right, you'll see Diana in her beautiful costume. And now, if you look to my left, you see that she has brought back the love of her life and stuffed him into somebody else's body. But there's no time to wait. There's no time to talk about that. Let's move on and check out Cheetah and Diana having a fight. And now let's check out this glorious wish stone and this dude, Lord, who wants to become the wish stone. But no time to look into that storyline either, because now we have to jump into this invisible plane, which the boyfriend who last flew in World War I can fly. And now let's reach the end of the movie and completely invalidate that plane by having Diana learn to fly by harnessing lightning bolts. The tour guide is talking a mile a minute without giving you a chance to take anything in and without taking the time to humanize the story. The experience of WW84 was so disjointed and the attention paid to the storyline so cursory that it would never occur to me to rewatch it. So to avoid overstuffing, consider each of your storylines and each of your major themes. If you have storylines that are not contributing to your major themes, consider cutting them. If you have more than three themes, ask yourself seriously if you are not just in danger of overstuffing your story. And if you think you might be in danger of character or world-building overstuffing, look at each element that you've introduced and ask yourself, does this contribute? Or is it just a cool, shiny toy to show off my amazing imagination? And if the answer is it's just a cool, shiny toy, consider cutting it. And that's my advice on overstuffing. I will see you soon for another episode of Just In Time Worlds. I hope that you enjoyed that episode of Just In Time Worlds. If you did, please do hit the thumbs up button. It really does help the channel grow. If you want to support me in making more of these videos, you can buy my book, The Hidden Blade, or you can visit my Ko-fi page where you can buy memberships, give one-off donations, or browse my shop for more. And I will see you soon for another episode of Just In Time Worlds.